Thank you. My personal engagement with the leadership, government, industry, and people of Japan is now a decade old. When I first visited Japan as Chief Minister of Gujarat, I had said that I want to see a mini Japan in Gujarat. Today, that dream has come true. I'm happy to see so many friends from Japan happily living and doing business in Gujarat. It also gives me great pleasure to see so many familiar faces. I'm also happy to see that dedicated township clusters and institutions have come up to make the Japanese life and work experience better. Today also, one Japanese township has been announced. Gujarat's industry and government still cherish the fact that Japan became the first partner country in the vibrant Gujarat event. Not only did this partnership continue, but our engagement has kept growing. It has resulted in much greater level of engagement of the Japanese industry with the Indian economy. I thank Kedanaran, JETRO, and other organizations for helping us in this process. The mechanism of Japan Plus has also helped in the process of hand-holding. Friends, the government and the people of Japan have always shown great affection towards me and my country. In fact, 1.25 billion people of India have the same affection for the Japanese people. I'm particularly grateful to Prime Minister Abe-san for the encouragement and support at a personal level. Prime Minister Abe-san and I do not miss any opportunity to meet. This closeness and understanding has helped us bridge a number of gaps in our bilateral relations. Last year has seen the highest ever disbursement of official development assistance from Japan in financial year. Similarly, the numbers of Japanese companies working in India had gone up steadily in the last few years. From the activities launched today, you can see the depth of relationship between the two countries. First, it is the Mumbai-Ahmedabad high-speed rail project. We are grateful for the support of the Japanese government for this project. I hope that the construction of the 500 kilometer long bullet train will begin soon and it will become operational by 2022 to 2023. Along with the high speed rail project, a training institute is also taking shape. It will prepare the makers of a new India, the highly skilled manpower required to build, operate and maintain the high-speed railway. Second is the development of Japanese industrial township. Countrywide, four locations have been finalized apart from Gujarat, they are located in Rajasthan, Andhra Pradesh, and Tamil Nadu. Third is our cooperation in automobiles. The Suzuki plant at Mandal is exporting cars worldwide, and foundation has been laid for production of lithium-ion batteries to power the next generation hybrid and electric vehicles. Fourth, it for human resource development through the Japan-India Institutes of Manufacturing. They are being developed by Japanese companies. In addition to Gujarat, they will be developed in Karnataka, Rajasthan, and Tamil Nadu. You know that the ancient and holy city of Varanasi, and Varanasi is my second home. The project of Varanasi Convention Center is a symbol of cultural cooperation between Kyoto, city of Japan, and Varanasi. It was conceived by Prime Minister Abe Sham and I when we visited Varanasi together in 2015. I have named this project as a Rudraksh, the symbol of love and prasad of Lord Shiva to humanity. This Rudraksh will be a garland of love of Japan for Varanasi. It will also be a tribute to our shared Buddhist heritage present at Sarnath too. For Japan's financial assistance to this project, I extend my warmest personal thanks to Prime Minister Abe Sham. We have also seen some other announcements for investment by Japanese companies. On political and strategic side too, this visit of Prime Minister Abe has been very productive. We have concluded a number of agreements of very important matters. All this shows the depth of our understanding and the comfort and confidence which we have with each other. Friends, over the last 3 years, we have worked very hard on the front of ease of doing business. A series of administrative reforms have significantly improved the business sentiment in the country. These reforms and initiatives are all aimed at preparing India for the 21st century New India. They are aimed at transforming the country and making a new India. Powered by the energy of our youth, we are positioning India as a global manufacturing hub. For this purpose, we have launched the Make in India campaign. We are also developing India into a knowledge-based, skill-supported and technology-driven society. A grand beginning has already been made through our drives like Digital India and Skill India. For the same purpose, we have started the Startup India campaign. India is ranked third. My young friends, you will be happy. India is ranked third in the global startup ecosystem and has seen a momentous rise in the past couple of years. The Startup India initiative also aims to build a strong ecosystem of innovation. On infrastructure side also, my government had launched ambitious initiatives. These projects create and present lifetime opportunities to investors. This includes 100 smart cities mission, housing for 50 million homeless, building roads, bridges, ports, railway tracks, as well as railway stations. Friends, Japan can benefit tremendously with the size and scale of our potential and skilled hands that India offers. In fact, all of India's development agenda is relevant for Japanese companies. To allow entry of capital and technology, we have worked hard on opening our economy. Every day, we are making it easier to invest and do business in India.
Post your comments below. And if you like this video, please give a thumbs up and follow us on social networks and subscribe to our channel. And thanks for watching. This is WC Daily. Think big, think different. Bye.